On August 28, 1963, more than 200,000 Americans gathered for the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom. A peaceful, nonviolent, but militant statement that the indignities of segregation would no longer be tolerated. This following a bloody spring and summer.
After facing the dogs and the fire hoses, going to Washington was a Sunday school picnic.
But the minute you conquer the fear of death at that moment,
Dr. Martin Luther King emerged from a Birmingham jail that spring with a national following for his policy of nonviolence.
He did more than dream. He was a fighter with a very radical vision for what this country should be and what it needed to be.
At noon, thousands started to arrive by train, by bus, by car, and gathered at the Washington Monument, and then the march to the Lincoln Memorial.
America has given the Negro people a bad check. A check which has come back marked insufficient funds.
But the most famous parts of the speech were delivered like a sermon to the faithful.
He was almost finished, really gathering up his notes, almost ready to finish. And the famous story that Mahalia Jackson, the gospel singer, yelled out to him from behind. She said, Martin, tell him about your dream. And it was at that point.
I have a dream. But one day, this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
The impact was not lost on a young president, John Kennedy, who invited the leaders to the White House that afternoon.
That was the meeting that assured that we would have a comprehensive Civil Rights Act introduced by the Kennedy administration.
A transformative moment to make America a more equal, more just society. Tom Ritchie, Associated Press.